Well, everything that we're doing today is directly related back to what happened in 1916 and the declaration of the leaders of the 1916 in writing that they declared the right of the people of Ireland to the ownership of Ireland. And Ireland for them was every one of Ireland's 32 counties. That always needs to be remembered. And our primary political objective as a Republican Party with a very strong sense of social justice is to achieve the fulfillment of their dreams. And to do it now as a result of those negotiations that we've been involved in by purely peaceful and democratic means. So that's how we go forward. At the moment, we face a huge crisis within the political process. And this huge crisis doesn't come about as a result of differences between Peter Robinson and I over unionism and republicanism. It doesn't come about as a result of the challenges that we face in regard to the constitutional position or national identity or anything like that, although these are all issues that we have to deal with in terms of the past, the issue of parades, and the whole issue of flag symbols and identity. Pressure that this administration is under at the moment is because we are faced with a British poorly led administration that is intent on crucifying this executive, that's intent on pummeling the most vulnerable people within our society. And if you listen to George Osborne's budget in the course of the last number of hours and the declaration that they intend to take £12 billion out of support for welfare for some of the most vulnerable within our society. We had the Institute for Fiscal Studies yesterday say that they only know where £2 billion of that will come out of, and they're demanding to know where the other £10 billion will come from. Well, it can only come from the most vulnerable within our society. It can only come from withdrawal of support for disabled children, disabled adults with severe disabilities, the long-term sick, and families with large numbers of children. And of course the Proclamation declared the right of the people of Ireland to the ownership of Ireland, but also declared the right of the children of Ireland to be treated equally and with dignity and respect. And I get fed up when I hear some commentators and journalists say things like, Sinn Féin stand up for these groups in the north because they have to, because it's a very important part of what Sinn Féin is doing in Dublin. And I regard that as an insult, because that suggests that we only do these things because we are only really interested in building Sinn Féin as a political party in the south, and that we really don't care about disabled children, disabled adults, the long-term sick, or families with large numbers of children. So I am insulted by that, because they are the people that we care about, and they are the people in this negotiation that we are attempting to defend. And I make no apology. I make no apology to anybody for that. When it's coming down the tracks at us, if this Tory-led administration is elected in the course of the next number of weeks, I think are disastrous consequences for this executive that I am honoured to be part of on the basis of equality and working with our unionist colleagues, our brothers and sisters. So this Tory administration doesn't get it in relation to a society emerging from conflict, doesn't get it when it has to consider the consequences of not recognising that people who have been through a conflict deserve to benefit from the fruits of peace. A benefit from the fruits of peace is about giving people a decent job, it's about providing proper public services for citizens, and it is about standing up for the most vulnerable disadvantaged, marginalised and disabled within our society. And we at Sinn Féin are proud to do that. And we will do that even at the cost of expense to ourselves. If this Tory led administration thinks that Sinn Féin is going to bend the knee in the face of their austerity agenda, then they are sadly mistaken. So they need to get it, and they need to recognise that the connection between the political circumstances, the austerity agenda that's been impacted on the most marginalised within society, is a serious issue for us, and in fact is more important than anything else that we are about at this time. And I believe that the inspiration for all of us as we continue to do that work is the leadership shown by the leaders of the 1916 Rising, when they went out to strike for Ireland's freedom and declared the right of the people of Ireland to the ownership of Ireland. So let's go from here inspired by those people. Let's go from here rejuvenated in the belief that this is the most exciting period in almost 100 years for Sinn Féin, and astounding us to do look at what we want in relation to achieving that primary political objective, not just of Sinn Féin in the 2016, but of the leaders of the 1916 and 1916.